What's up, everybody? Welcome to the first episode of Bulldog Banter. The purpose of this is to bring personalities out of athletes. We learn their stories, their backgrounds, and really why they went into the sport that they are at here at Wingate. Donny Chiarel, my co-host, Sam Hyman with you. Donny, just give the folks a little bit of background on yourself.
All right, so like Sam said, I'm Donny Chiarel. I'm a sophomore here at Wingate. I'm a sports broadcasting major, and I'm just excited to be doing this, excited to talk to our athletes. Let's get going.
You know, I was a sports broadcasting major back
then. No way.
Yes.
Small world.
Graduated from Syracuse in 2016, so a little bit old now. Feels
a little
weird.
Older. Yeah. You can rent a car now.
I can.
You're 25.
Yes. Our first guest is from the Wingate volleyball team. Let's give it up for Lynnlee Mather. Woo!
What's up, Lynnlee? How are you?
Hey, guys. I'm good. How are you?
Doing great. Doing
Welcome. Great. Are you excited to be on the first ever
yes.
Bulldog Banter?
I'm super excited.
All right. Well, let's get to it. Yep. Being on the volleyball team, going back to your freshman year when you kind of started this whole journey, what do you remember about the decision and why you ultimately chose Wingate?
Why I chose Wingate?
Why?
Why? The big why.
The big why.
Well, a lot of it had to do with Coach reaching out to me. I think that was one of the biggest things, knowing that he just has a really good program, and the girls that come through, they get better as they, like, when they leave, and that's not just physically, but also their characteristics too. So I thought that was really huge. They obviously, Wingate obviously wins games, so that's a
very
that's
true.
A reason
pretty,
to go.
Pretty good program.
Yeah. And I really wanted to go Division One, and I wanted to go Division One, and the Division One schools I was looking at was actually getting beat in the spring by Wingate. So I was like, okay,
wow.
Yeah.
That's an interesting.
Maybe.
Yeah. Wow.
So, and then also just when I came to the campus, I just loved it, and I loved the team too, and they all seemed like they were really interested in me as a person and having a life outside of volleyball as well, and I thought that was just really awesome. So I was excited about it.
So, of course, the main guy in all this, Shelton Collier.
Yeah.
Take us through the first phone call when he started recruiting you to this campus. What did he say to you, if you remember?
Yeah, so he was just like, hey, Lynnlee, like, and just started talking.
I can see it, yeah.
Just started talking.
I can see it, hear it.
Yeah, literally.
And he was just basically telling me how interested he was in me, and I think that meant a lot to me, especially back then, because, like I said, I was looking at other schools, but they just weren't as intentional with me, and
right.
I was kind of like one person on their list of other people they were looking at, and with Coach, he was like, well, we really want you, and we can really see you fitting in and you playing here and your personality. I think that's what really got me, too. It wasn't just like, you're talented and we can see potential. It was like, we like your personality, too, and that will bring a lot to our team. And so, and also, like, telling me that I could also have a shot freshman year playing. And so I thought that was, that's something that really.
That is really cool. Especially, like, I mean, you kind of get lost in, like, the D1 recruiting process, like
right.
you said, you're just like a person on a board, but like here at Wingate, you know, there's not as many people
right.
obviously, so you kind of get to have that life outside of volleyball. That's cool. I like
so you brought up personality and how it fits here at Wingate. What is your personality that you bring to Wingate and that you have brought to Wingate to this point, now being a senior?
I think that something that Coach always talks about is like this Wingate vibe, and it's not just Coach talking about it, it's us, like, as a team, like taking in this whole thing, this culture. And so I guess personality-wise, it's just like everybody being selfless and wanting each other to succeed. And so it's like, I'm gonna do this for you. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm going to do what I can to make me better, to make you better, so that we can all be better and eventually win matches. But it's kind of, we have a saying called, give your teammates what you need. It's in our locker room, it's hanging up. And it's just what kind of drives our team. And so I think that when Coach recruits, he's like looking for people who can evolve and adapt to that and eventually give their teammates, or from day one, give their teammates what they need and want everybody to succeed. So.
You've evolved and adapted, I think, throughout the course of your career. I mean, you've grown in a lot of areas on the court and in your senior years coming up, but going back to your junior year, you had one, you know, setback, obviously, where you tore your ACL. Can you walk us through what was going through your mind during that moment and kind of how your look on the sport and your ability to be out there changed, or What was going through your head?
It definitely put me in a different place. So it put me in more of a place of like observing the game rather than being out there and being playing in the matches. And it was cool to see everybody playing, but of course it made me like super upset that I couldn't be mm-hmm. physically out there. I had a lot of emotions when it happened. I was really in shock, so it didn't really settle in until it yeah. settled in like the next morning and I was in a lot of pain. But it happened so quick, and it was what it was, and I feel like I just
it's tough. I mean,
yeah. Yeah, I was gonna say, you can't even.
I haven't experienced a torn ACL. I have no idea, but I mean you hear about it so many times, it kind of sometimes just gets, oh, you know, this person tore ACL,
right,
or his ACL, you know, got to bounce back. But like for the individual athlete, it was, I mean, how difficult was it to navigate through the weeks, the months afterwards?
So at first it wasn't as hard because my whole team was super there for me. Everybody was cheering me on, and I think that it's just, it happens and you're like, okay, well, what do I do with this? And my parents got to be there, which is really awesome. They weren't actually going to be there, and then the Hurricane Florence came in and they had to change their plans, so they
terrified
ended up
terrified of hurricanes.
Yep. but anyways, so
that was when I was a kid.
Not
okay.
anymore.
No.
We've passed that point.
Thankfully.
But yeah, so it was super awesome that they got to be there and I got to be with them that night. But they were constantly just reminding me, like, you know, God has a purpose in this.
Yeah.
Like you go through these moments, but this is what builds your character. You have to have endurance, and like
right.
it was a character building process, and it still is. And I've gotten to focus on a lot of things physically and mentally, and so and it ended up being a blessing. But going through that journey was really tough, and like there were definitely low points. I talked to a mm-hmm. lot of people and I'm like, ACL is so weird, your knees are so weird, because it's like one day you're like balling out and you have the best lift of your life, and then the next day you're like
right.
holy cow, I really did hurt myself, didn't I?
Right.
So but yeah, just having my family and my teammates and just everybody, like mm-hmm. everybody in the athletic department, everybody, all my teachers too. I had professors sending me notes every week, like in the mail, like just
handwritten.
Yes,
I will say, like, handwritten notes means so much.
Best thing
more.
To
it's right. it's remarkable. Like even if you send a thank you note after mm-hmm. something,
yeah.
something as small as that, and as
takes
powerful
time.
As you right. know. An occasion that you had to deal with.
Yeah, because you know how easy it is to like have the intention of writing a note and then never doing it.
Right.
But you
and
write it,
and you text
mail
it, and it's like, but the handwritten, it goes a long way.
Yeah.
So like obviously talking through your journey, mm-hmm. how are you right now physically? Like how close are you to returning? Have you returned? How's practice?
Yeah.
So just give us a quick update.
So for practice, I was a part of preseason. I got to practice. I was like what we like to say partly cleared. So mm-hmm. I got to do all of the practice things, just not compete and mm-hmm. go through like points and not like take a break and stuff. It had
right.
to be more controlled. I'm hoping to be cleared really soon, like mm-hmm. this week or maybe next week, so we'll see about that. But physically and mentally, I'm feeling really good, and I'm just really excited because I want to play and I want to be there with my team. I've been working really hard, and I just like, and a lot of it has been for me, but a lot mm-hmm. more of it has been for my team. So I just want to get to experience playing mm-hmm. with them on the court again. You kind of take for granted screaming to the top of your lungs for no reason. So
well, speaking of screaming and just the excitement that you are possessing here, like going back to last season and being on the sidelines
right.
during the Southeast region,
yeah.
Inside Cuddy Arena, the atmosphere, I mean, how was it for you kind of being obviously still a part of the team, but a spectator, knowing you weren't going to be out there and ultimately watching what your squad accomplished? And that's a Southeast region title, which is
right.
just awesome.
It was so amazing. It really was. And I think that the energy that was in that gym that weekend, and getting to go, knowing that we won regionals and getting to go to nationals for the first time for me. And I know a lot of the other girls, it was just like, amazing. And of course I wanted to be on the court for part of it or all of it or whatever, but I not getting to do that, it it would have been easy to feel kind of like cheated in a way because you don't get to actually participate on the court.
Yeah.
But my team made me feel so a part of it, like every step of the way. And I know that they were thinking about it too. I know that they weren't just like, they knew how I felt and they knew that like they wanted to include me in such a special moment. And so not for a second was I like, dang it, I have to sit on the sidelines. It was like I was in there with my team the whole time, and it was just, it was amazing.
That's awesome. Yeah. And that goes back to like we said, like with coach recruiting you guys to be more than volleyball players. That's like a, that's a family. I like that.
Yeah, for
sure. Cool. That's a cool insight.
Did you like learn those characteristics back home in Georgia? Like when you were playing in high school and middle school, I mean, how much of the stuff that you learned there has translated to being at Wingate?
It's kind of interesting because I talk to my mom about this all the time because we reflect a lot. You know, you call your mom on the phone and you're sitting there, you're like 5 minute conversation to an hour. Yeah.
Right.
My mom always expects me to call her. I'm like, mom, call me. Like, give me
a call. I call my mom every day, so.
Aww.
Really?
I do.
Sweet.
My mama's boy.
Set time?
It depends. Probably like later in the evening, like when everything's settled down. Because she works during the day.
Donnie's busy. He's got a busy day.
I'm a mama's boy. I'm not scared about it. So,
got to
call mom. Like Lynnlee said, there you go.
Exactly. But yeah, so a 5 minute conversation turns into like 2 hours of reflection. So, I feel like it became a whole new game when I came to school. I feel like some of the characteristics I learned at being at home more than on the court because it was never competitive before this. Like it wasn't the same. And like having a coach like constantly talk to you about what they want to see out of you as like a person and a player just changes your perspective on the game because then you actually like develop a love for it and you love it more than just a game. It's like a sport that you play with your best friends. And so in high school and playing club and stuff, it wasn't really like that. And so it was just something I did for fun. And it wasn't as like, oh my gosh, I really want to win this game. It's just like, this is nice and enjoyable. And hopefully I get to college doing this one day. So I would say that some of those characteristics I learned before college, but they just like came out more because I was playing with a team and I had a coach that brought that out of me too.
It's the Wingate vibe.
It's the Wingate culture. It's the Wingate vibe.
Yeah, Wingate vibe.
Yeah, no, exactly.
Are you like the first person in your immediate family or even extended family like that has gone the route of volleyball or
My dad played like sand volleyball and stuff but not like
not collegiate
Yes,
there you go.
Yes,
do you think how do you think you'd fare on the sand, like beach volleyball?
I love sand volleyball.
Are you pretty good at that?
I would say I'm pretty good. I haven't really played that much in a while though, but
I can't.
I mean, she's college volleyball player, so I would guess.
It's definitely.
Yeah, but it's a huge.
It's
adjustment.
Very different.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry.
You have
sand.
To like.
I'm sorry.
Sand? Are you kidding? It's different. This
it's
is flat.
Totally different.
No, you have to get your sand legs. So it takes a second to like get adjusted. You have to like actually be under the ball and jump up rather than like approach to it. So that's kind of different.
Yeah.
It's harder to move around. I don't know.
I think Kim Hovey was pretty good, one of your former teammates. She was super good at
sand volleyball.
You call it sand, not beach volleyball?
I mean, I usually call it sand just because it's not on the beach. But that's just me thinking literal about
it. No, that's fair. Yeah, definitely. There's like sand volleyball. Does that like help you when it comes to like maybe like conditioning or like certain ways to approach it? Because I'm not the biggest volleyball person. So like, take me through like the differences. I mean, obviously you said like setting yourself up like under the ball instead of just like attacking to it.
Yeah, so I'd say it's definitely more tiring as if you're outside and it's hot and then it's harder to move around in the sand and like run around and stuff. But it would be cool if we use it for conditioning. We usually don't, but I think it would be a lot of fun.
You got a
conditioning plan. There you go.
There's a beach volleyball set up over there.
Right there.
Yeah, it's down the road on campus.
It. Yeah, we'll just like put up a little umbrella, put them under the chair.
That's
the coach
collar.
I could see it. Short sleeve button down.
Table with the cup and
just like this little setup right here.
What is
exactly?
What's like the Shelton Collier phrase during a practice or a match that he says all the time? That's like, heard this. This is it.
Recently, it's been. This is so cool. He also says fired up a lot.
Okay.
I'm fired
this is
up.
So cool.
That's usually with recruiting. I feel like he's like, I'm so fired
up about
you.
I thought you were talking about the Bulldog
Me too.
Banter.
Yeah.
This Bulldog Banter
it's okay.
is super cool.
So, super cool. Of course. This is cool. This is really cool. No, but that's
Sweet.
Like his But yeah, that's like his number one phrase.
What's like the most memorable story about Coach that you've had so far in your Wingate career? Like in the locker room, like after a game, like has he ever said anything that just like blows you away?
Okay. Wait, like in a deep way or like something
anyway,
that he's
like,
done that's like pretty
funny?
Funny?
Yeah, just for the sake of the show.
But I have two things. So one of them was he came in with the regional trophy and was like, wow, this is heavy. And then was like, and also when we went to, three things. When we went to Nationals, he brought out, because you know the whole theme last fall was like, let's get this bread. It's still going. It's still trending hash.
Right.
It's still a trending hashtag, but he brought a loaf of bread out on the court in Pittsburgh at Nationals, and I lost it.
That's awesome.
But I think he'll appreciate this story. Went back during my freshman year, we went to this, when we were playing at Flagler, we went to this, I think it was Salt Life restaurant. And
in
he
Florida?
Was, yeah, in Florida.
Yeah, I couldn't tell you.
I couldn't either, really.
Yeah,
but
don't know many restaurants.
He was looking through the menu, and I guess he saw that there was a margarita called Tsunami, and that's a volleyball club I played at in high school. And he said,
"That's a sweet name."
Yeah,
that is cool
for a club volleyball team.
Yeah, go Big Wave. Anyways, he was like,
plug.
There's
plug.
Plug.
Your plug to come later.
But anyways, he was like, if your club name is a margarita on this menu, I'll get it for you. And we were all like, what? And so we looked through and it was Tsunami was on there. So he got it for me. And I told my parents and I was like, it was virgin, of course. But
that's
really
cool.
Funny.
That's really cool.
Yeah.
So let's switch things up a little bit. What are some things? Yeah, switch it up.
There's a good dance called Switch It Up.
Really?
Yeah, the volleyball team will do it for you. Whenever.
No kidding.
We can make a video.
That's
about
a challenge.
Okay. Sam, we gotta note that.
Seriously.
Yeah. Future reference. If we see y'all walking around.
It's literally called Switch It Up.
So like if I saw like a group of volleyball players walking and I said Switch It Up, would they like know?
Yeah, I think so. You just have to, maybe not the freshmen. We're kind of like teaching. Actually,
them
I think
ways.
They know it.
Has it been here since you got here as a freshman, or is it?
No,
like
it's a song that came out last year. It's called Switch Up. It's like lean with it, dab with it.
Oh, yeah.
No, all right, all right. Let's actually switch it up.
Okay, sorry. Okay. Sorry.
I mean,
bring it up.
Goodness
gracious. Sorry.
Yeah. What are some things that you like to do outside of volleyball?
Outside of volleyball.
What
well,
can we find Lynnlee Mather doing outside of
on an off day?
I'm not, I would probably be studying. Not something I necessarily like.
Yeah.
I do like some classes.
Studying's
I enjoy because
cool.
I enjoy my major. But, anyways, no, I love hanging out with my friends, hanging out with my team, playing games together.
What kind
of
games?
Of games. Play the family game. Have you heard
family
of it?
Never heard of it.
Never.
You've heard of it?
No, I have not.
Okay, so basically, you have a lot of people, and there's a limit on the amount of people you can have. Only 10.
There. Only
no,
ten.
I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. As many people as many
that's
people as you
of,
want.
That's a lot of people.
As many
for a game.
People
it
as
is.
You want.
I feel like 4 or 5 is max. Yeah.
No. This is inclusive, not exclusive. So
right.
Any amount of people, and if it's a larger amount of people, you have two people. You write down a famous person's name or anybody that everybody in the group could know, and so you and your partner come up with a name. You put it in a box or whatever hat, and then you mix it up, and one person reads out all the names twice.
Okay.
With me, and time. Then and then you have to remember.
I've never heard of this.
Okay, no, so I... this example, me and Don, we're partners. Mm-hmm. Me and Donnie are partners.
Who's we my write, partner? No one. Sorry.
I'm just kidding. well, I'll be partner.
Our executive producer.
Exactly. No, but anyway, so you memorize the list of names, and then you have to guess who said what name. And if you guess that group right, like you said, who's your favorite actor?
Jake Gyllenhaal.
You wrote down Jake Gyllenhaal. And
Donnie's like, he's starstruck that I just like.
No, that's a good answer.
My, yeah.
I'm not a huge movie buff.
Yeah.
So I'm actually kind of surprised that.
That you thought of that.
I was, because I was like, crap, like I have many favorite actors, but who's the top one that was just
That was a good
right
answer.
That's a good. That was
I'm
a good
proud
one,
of you.
Sam. That's actually like, I'm impressed. I'm proud of you.
We're all proud.
That's a good answer.
All right. So wait.
So
get back.
I'm sorry. So basically, Donnie knows you so well, and he knows that you would put Jake Gyllenhaal, right?
Easily.
Of course. So he's gonna be like, Sam, you and your executive producer definitely said Jake Gyllenhaal. And so if you're like, yes, that was me, then you become part of our family. That's how it works. But if we get it wrong, then we get it wrong, and then you get to guess what other people are.
How does it end?
Whoever has all the people, so it will get down to two families, big families, and then you, whoever's turn it was.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
So that sounds fun.
There's no car, like, it's just, you know, rip pieces of paper.
Yeah, no, you rip pieces of paper.
So you don't buy this game anywhere.
No. It's just you play it,
Did you make this up? Did
organic.
Anybody like?
No, when I came in as a freshman, we played it with our team and a couple other, I think it was maybe some baseball guys, and we all played.
Gotcha.
And it was really cool because it was like, it made everybody comfortable with each other. But right now, I think Ann Abernathy is the reigning champion of the game. She'll sit there and just know exactly who. I don't know how she does it. She doesn't even read out the names, but yeah.
So games. What else? Are you super active on social media? Like what?
Yeah, I would say so.
What?
Like, what's your go-to social media?
I really I love Instagram for posting stuff because I don't have Twitter. I feel like I really should get a Twitter because like I want to see Wingate Bulldogs.
I was trying to trying to get people to follow like Wingate Athletics, and I would go up to them like around campus and I go up to them and I'd say give us a follow on Twitter and Instagram, and a lot of them just said they had an Instagram.
Really?
Twitter is, I love Instagram, but Twitter's that's your news. Like
yeah,
I wake up in the morning, I scroll through Twitter and I look for the information.
What kind of information are we talking
about?
Sports, like what kind of news?
Sports. Yeah. When you go to the search page
around the world, because I don't watch CNN or I don't watch.
How do you know it's like legitimate, like good information?
Verified accounts.
Verified accounts.
If they're verified,
if you go to the search page, it like pulls up like what's trending.
Okay.
Like certain news events, because Twitter's evolved.
Twitter so really has evolved. Like you've never had a Twitter.
No.
Oh my god.
I'll search on Safari like Wingate Bulldogs Twitter page. So that's the only thing I look at.
Interesting.
Yep. But anyway,
that's another plug.
Plugs everywhere. Yeah. But yeah, no, I enjoy Instagram, Snapchat, but Snapchat's not really. It's definitely a social media.
It is, but I know what you mean. It's more of like communicating. It's not necessarily like.
If I like deleted Snapchat, I wouldn't talk to a lot of people. You know, like that's how people communicate with me.
That's like how today
is. You know what I'm saying?
Like, yeah.
So you don't communicate on Instagram with people.
I mean, sometimes, but it's like kind of weird.
Yeah.
Literally,
it's not
it's a
that
different
weird.
Animal.
Especially if how old am I?
<Just kidding. laughs>
If you post something on if you post something on Instagram and it's like, wow, like this person's at this event.
Yeah.
And I want to respond to them and I want to say, wow, that's really cool.
Yeah. You know what I've been doing lately though is the quick responses. You know when you like slide up a little
bit? Yes, that's an easy
one. I did it on accident the first time. I don't remember who it was that I accidentally put thumbs up to,
I don't use Snapchat that much. Just because I feel like it's fizzling.
Go ahead.
Fizzling out.
Oh my gosh.
No, I don't think it's fizzling out. Well, I think it's more of just communicating.
I feel like people don't ask for numbers anymore. It's like, hey, add me on Snap. And then I'll text you on Snap.
Are you not familiar with that terminology?
add me on Snap.
I've been,
I'm just kidding.
Yeah, add me on Snap. Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
All right.
Well, let's switch things up a little more. Okay. Get away from the social
Switching
media.
Switching up.
Not really like switch up that, you know. But we saw that you took a trip to Ireland.
Yes, I did.
This past spring, how was that?
It was really fun. Okay. I've always wanted to go there. I really love green grass. Yeah, that might sound weird, but I'm like, I really like green grass.
So your heart smiles like if you see like a
literally like if I see a really pretty landscape, like I will tear up. I'm
wait, so what does that have to do with Ireland?
Ireland's really pretty and it has a lot of pretty green grass.
Come on, Sam.
Okay.
Keep up.
Well, there are a lot of places though that have green grass.
No, that's true. But
like,
when we looked at the
there's something else that sticks out about Ireland, right? It's not just the green grass.
No, it's just the green grass. No, but like when we like looked through the things to pick, that's true.
That's funny. That's funny.
When we looked through the list, it was like that and Estonia, which I didn't really do much for. I don't really know much about Estonia. But then there was Japan and.
Is there green grass there too?
Who knows? I just searched Ireland. You search Ireland pigs, really pretty green grass.
All right, you know what? I'll hold you to it. Okay. There's probably. What is there anything else?
Yeah, so we went to Dublin, and that has a lot of historical things going on.
Yeah.
And then we went to, the whole international class, the point of it is to take a class. We learned a lot about some poetry and some famous poets.
That's cool.
And so it was actually really cool because we went to Ireland, and then we got to see, like, have you guys heard of William Butler Yeats?
It rings a bell, but like I don't.
You
know.
Read for pleasure, like the poet. Yeah. No, I'm just
not
kidding.
Really. You don't read.
Nicholas Sparks. They're right some. Up at the same. I'm just kidding.
Okay. Lynnlee was talking, so we'll let Lynnlee finish before we get.
Wow. Shots fired.
Shut down. No, but anyway, so we got to see like where he wrote his poetry and stuff like that,
that's
which
cool.
was really pretty.
Yeah.
And so yeah, and then we went to Galway, which was really cool, and they're really, really nice cities. And then also saw the Cliffs of Moher. Have you guys? Heard of that?
No.
Oh,
that
okay.
actually that sounds
more familiar than
Butler Yeats. I've only been to one part of one country in Europe. Only one.
Iceland?
Yes. Yeah, Iceland.
What's the capital? You know?
Do you know?
Starts with an N, I think.
No. Why would you ask me this question? If you
I thought it was a good question.
Reykjavik. But yeah.
What?
Just slips off the tongue.
Would you ever consider living overseas?
Yes, of course.
Do you want to?
I would love to, actually. I was younger, I lived in Australia. I was like 4, 5, and 6. So
do you remember like anything or?
Yeah, some? I do. I remember a lot, actually. That's cool. I don't know. It was that weird time when you're a child and you remember a lot of stuff that happened.
All blur. All blur.
Really?
I get that.
Sorry.
I don't remember anything when I was 5 years old, 6 years old.
You're a little bit older now, so it's... So
all right.
That makes sense. This is that makes sense. Like, we're really closer to that age.
So 10 years from now, where do you see yourself 10 years from now?
10 years from now?
Deep.
I don't know.
It's a deep question.
I really...
Look into
hopefully
the future.
Married. I really want to be a PA, so doing something with that. I want to have kids, too, so hopefully a family. Being a PA.
Living where?
Cool. Living where? I don't know. I really don't know.
Buy some green grass.
But exactly. So maybe I'll say North Carolina. Georgia has some nice grass. I don't know. We'll see.
You don't know yet?
Probably like kind of close to a city, but not too close. I don't know.
I don't want to live like in a city. I'm with you on that.
But like, yeah.
I agree.
That's not ideal. Too much traffic.
Yeah,
claustrophobic,
a
lot of things going on. I just want some peace, but I want a 10-minute drive to
exactly.
the city.
Exactly.
10-15-minute drive to the city.
Right.
Yeah.
So one other thing we found out about you is that you like to surf.
I like to surf, yes.
Take
I
us
do like
that.
To surf. So
is that like your go-to thing? Like if you go to the beach, like do you say, I'm going to lay out and tan, or, oh, I got to surf?
Okay, well, funny thing is I learned how to surf one time when I was 9 years old.
Okay.
Who taught you?
Some surfer guy from Hawaii.
Some surfer guy?
I have no idea.
Don't remember his name.
No, there's no shot. I remember stuff when I was 4, 5, and 6, but I can't
that
remember anything
when I'm
9. That
was honestly a dumb question. How could you remember this person's name when you're 9 years old?
But ever since then, I've never surfed. So.
Never?
I mean, like, well,
how in the world do you surf when you're 9?
Because
that
we had surf, we had surfing lessons, and I feel like it's easy when you're smaller. But then, I don't know. I boogie board, but that's like you catch a wave
board.
And you kind of get yeah.
It's pretty easy.
But yeah.
Okay, so
now I lay out and tan.
Low blow.
But yeah.
I think that's, cool. that's one of like trying to boogie board versus surf. Totally
different animals. One takes athletic ability, another one.
Yeah.
Just kind of hold on for dear life. But yeah.
So you got an Apple Watch on?
Yes.
Is that? Give me a pitch for me to get an Apple Watch.
An Apple Watch?
Yeah.
I don't think it's worth the money.
Thank you. I mean, this is
yikes.
This is the conversation.
This was given to me. So, I probably should get an updated one, but I. Probably
what's
won't.
What's
you're saying, you're saying that an Apple Watch is not...
What series do you have?
I don't know. I don't even know what series it is.
When did
That's
you get
how much
it?
I
so,
Wow, okay.
No, but listen,
I'm with you. Cheers.
It's nice. Sorry, put it down.
Sorry, okay. I'll go later.
No, but it's nice because, like, you know when you get text. I think the nicest thing for me is I never see know when I get phone calls. And so that's what's nice. But, I mean, you can do that on.
I like having a different style watch every time I wear something. Like, I actually, funny story about this watch, it's actually dead. It's not even working. But
That's the point of a watch.
I still wear it, though.
I literally was going to tell you that you shouldn't get an Apple Watch because it's getting away from the actual watch, the reason you need it. But yours is dead anyways.
No, but, like, the style of the watch.
Why are you wearing a dead watch?
Are you left-handed?
I'm going to get a new one, okay? Yeah, I am left-handed.
Okay, but I'm just making sure.
No, I'm with you on, like, having
but you
a different
can change
style
the color.
Because the Apple Watch looks the same.
Yeah, but you can change the color of the band.
I was going to say, you get a different band.
You're
going
to get a different band every day.
Like
you could get that same exact band, I'm pretty sure.
Oh, wait, so you're,
don't quote me
you're
on
advocating
that.
For an Apple Watch, but you just said that it's not worth the money.
I don't think... I'm in a tough spot because mine was given to me, so it's like I'm thankful that
I got this.
You know
so
what
now
I'm saying?
That we're on this subject, do you have AirPods?
No.
There we go. Right. Are they worth the money?
We know you have AirPods because you wear Lululemon pants.
Cheers.
Thank you. Put that down.
Do you think they're worth the money?
Actually, AirPods are really cool though.
Okay.
I just don't have them.
Right.
But I like that you can like skip songs or like take one out and it pauses. Like that's sick.
That is cool. If they but I mean, I'd rather have a watch. I'd rather have a nice watch.
All right.
Like an Apple Watch.
I don't know what I'd rather have.
This was a Sam and I got into this.
Wasn't this a question?
It
thing?
Was. We had it on our Twitter. This
was,
or
yeah,
that.
Yes, it was this
I
or that.
Actually
that
saw
first
that.
One.
Even though I don't have a Twitter.
Apple Watch won.
You saw it, really? But you didn't have
I
a Twitter.
Saw, well, I saw.
Well, she said that she looked up. Yeah.
How it got. Viral. How,
okay, so the reason I actually ended up watching it is because you asked the question, would you rather fly or talk to animals?
That was a hit.
And you asked one of my teammates, Reese.
Reese.
And she said, I'd rather fly because we already talk to animals. They just don't talk back. And
was,
I was like,
you know that emoji
crazy.
Where the head explodes?
Yeah.
That's like your favorite emoji.
That was me.
I think that's Reese in a nutshell.
Anyways, it's trivia time. Hashtag trivia time. This
I
segment,
love hashtags.
The purpose of this segment is to see if you know some things about your teammates, your coach.
Okay, here we go.
Some trivia.
Please, no one get offended if I get it wrong.
Start us off, Sam.
So, the first question for you, how many times has Shelton Collier won SAC Coach of the Year over the last 12 seasons? How many times has he won SAC Coach of the Year over the last 12 seasons?
11 times.
Close.
You're close.
But no cigar. The answer was 10.
10. Okay.
But you're.
That was a good guess.
Yeah. I mean,
yeah,
legend.
I just thought it wasn't.
Right, yeah. 10, 11, 12.
I was really going to guess 12, but I thought that when we didn't win it the one year that he. I don't know. I was trying to think logically, but.
Next
so
up.
0 for 1.
Next
so
up.
All right. Thanks.
You still have time. It's okay. I just have to let you know.
Thank you.
What is the capital of Australia?
I wish I. Oh my gosh. Is it Sydney?
It is not Sydney.
Is it Melbourne?
It is Canberra.
Canberra.
I did not know that.
I didn't know it either. Glad I didn't have to answer
that. But you know the capital of Iceland, so it's all good.
I do.
What is it again?
Chill.
I'm not making fun of you.
Reykjavik.
He's making fun
right?
of you.
If you want to ask someone from Iceland how to pronounce it better than me, do that.
Yeah, because I know everyone.
Okay. Another trivia. Third trivia question. Ready for this one?
Yes. Sorry.
No, you're good. In 2016,
yes.
Who were the top three players in order? Like list them in order. The top three players on your team in kills that year.
2016.
Your freshman year.
I was freshman year.
Who were the top three
Abby
players?
Abby Saylor.
That would be one.
One.
Okay. Two, three.
Who? Okay, this is hard.
I think if she guesses
Phoebe?
The other two. Yeah. Then it'll be okay.
Phoebe
just think
didn't
your freshman
play.
Year.
Phoebe
so
didn't play. Anna was out for ankle. I'm trying to. Tyler Smith is probably in the top three. I played a lot. I might be in the top three. Or Taylor Williams.
In 26.
Right, so what's your definite
Wait,
three?
Katie Bludow played too.
Whoa.
I forgot about Whoa. Katie.
She did play
she
that
did
year.
Play that year. Okay, I want to go Abby, Katie, and then maybe me. just because of the
coaching. So you've got one in the right place,
okay.
One that's correct but in the wrong place, and then you didn't name a correct one. So
okay.
I'm going to give you the order. Abby Saylor, one.
One.
Oakley Attaway, two.
Oh, Oakley.
Yeah.
Okay.
Katie Blue Dow, three.
Okay. That makes sense.
So.
I immediately thought middles.
Yeah.
But anyways.
That was good.
That was good.
Thank you.
All right. This one's good. I showed this to Sam before, and we both shared a quick little laugh. I think it's a good question. What is the Italian word for pie? Think about it. You're going to feel like really, if you don't get it, you're going to be mad at yourself.
Is it pizza?
It is pizza.
No way.
Yes. High five. There we go.
Thanks.
Pizza.
Check.
Got
wow.
It.
And then
I'm
the last trivia question.
Okay.
How well do you, this, okay. What is Rachel Alice's middle name?
Nicole.
Okay.
So easy. She's in my class.
I feel like
come on, Tom.
Sometimes okay. People like forget their friends'
yes.
middle names.
Okay. Do you want to know a funny fact about that?
Yeah. Always.
So Treslin and her have been roommates since freshman year.
Yes.
And their initials are Tom Ran. So like if you get a monogram, because you know how the last name is in the middle.
Yes.
So it's
like you,
Treslin.
Do you have that on your cup?
Yeah.
I had to call that, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I don't really like monograms, but I like this one. No, but yeah, so it's Tom
that's
Rand.
Cool.
Them to
that's
cool.
That's fun.
I thought it was pretty
that
funny.
That is interesting.
Yeah.
All right, so you're past the trivia.
I made
you
it past.
Yeah,
sorry,
you
Oakley.
You did a good job. You did a good
sorry.
Job.
Yeah. Yeah, you did.
We'll end it. We'll end the Bulldog Banter with plug.
With a plug.
So anything you'd like to tease coming up? I know
yes.
first home match.
Yes, our first home match is September 10th. And it's at 7:00, so I hope you can make it and be there for us and be encouraging.
I'll
I know
there.
You will be there. Will you be there?
Of course.
Okay.
There.
Well, then we're good. We're good.
Of course.
All right, Lynnlee, thanks so much for joining us. First episode, Bulldog Banter in the books. I appreciate your time. We had a blast.
Thank you so much.
It was an honor to be here.
Loved
thanks
it.
For inviting
Sam,
me.
Sam, Lynnlee, Donny.
We out.
We're out.
Peace.